I'm in a location that was a starting place to probably one of the biggest massacres in U.S. history. And that was the beginning of the raid on Lawrence, Kansas. And they were going to be right over that hill. So if you look over there where the bend is and those trees, right along that creek over there, what you're going to find is a place where over 200 men gathered in this very location to perform probably one of the most unbelievable massacres in U.S. history. You know, this was retaliation.
The retaliation at Lawrence was due to an incident that happened on this very spot at the Union prison collapse. The Union believed the only way they were going to be able to contain the bushwhackers was to eliminate their supply chain, so they rounded up all the relatives, all the females of these bushwhackers, and put them in this very location. Needless to say, the prison collapsed, whether that be by neglect or other measures, killing members of the bushwhackers, including this young girl who happened to be the sister of Bloody Bill Anderson. From there on, all bets were off and all hell broke loose. The prison was owned by Jacob Caleb Bingham, world-famous artist, who happens to be buried nearby Josephine. In retaliation to Lawrence, the Union ordered General Order No. 11, August 25, 1863, forcing the abandonment of rural areas in four counties in western Missouri. The order actually put as much stress on the Union side as it did the Confederates, which actually didn't decrease the help, it actually increased and backfired. Bingham was so outraged, and he also owned the prison that had collapsed. He made this painting of Order No. 11. It was painted on this very spot on the original porch of this house. This picture haunted General Ewing, who issued the order. Actually, the order was repealed, but this picture was used to ruin Ewing's political career for the rest of his life.